Now I read at verse 24, and the 10 horns out of the kingdom are 10 kings that shall arise, and another shall arise after them, and he shall be diverse from the first, and he shall subdue 3 kings. Now, the thing that interests us here is that there were 10 horns that came out of the beast, and these 10 horns are 10 kings, and a king represents a kingdom, of course. And then we are told that among these 10 kings, another one, that would be 11th one, will arise. And he's going to be diverse from the first. That is, he'll be different from all those that have come. And he will move to power by subduing 3 kings. That more or less gives him a majority. And he'll move to world power. He'll become actually the dictator of the entire world. And very candidly, that is the picture that's presented to us in the 13th chapter of Revelation. And verse 7 of Revelation 13, it was given unto him to make war with the saints, to overcome them, and power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. Now, just as the Caesars ruled over the world of that day, and we've already seen what Gibbon had to say about that, and I'd like to repeat that because it's very important. He says the empire of the Romans filled the world, and when the empire fell into the hands of a single person, the world became a safe and dreary prison for his enemies. To resist was fatal, and it was impossible to fly. And that was a picture, an accurate picture. And Gibbon further made it clear what we're talking about here, that there be no guesswork. He says the 4 empires are clearly delineated, and the invincible armies of the Romans described with as much clearness in the prophecies of Daniel as in the histories of Justin and Diodorus. So that we have before us here this 4th empire, and we're somewhere in it. Now, there will come out of this empire 10 kings, and they will come back together again, but there will arise one, and he'll be this little horn. He'll be this man of sin, the Antichrist, and he's going to rule over the world. He moves to world power, and that'll take place in the Great Tribulation period, a period, we believe, of 7 years. Now, notice, though, what verse 25 said. He shall speak great words against the Most High, and he shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time. Now, the little horn is a blasphemer. We find that again in the 13th of Revelation. We are told here, verse 5, and there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things and blasphemies. And verse 6, he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle. And one of the characteristics of Antichrist is the fact that he's against God. And against Christ. That's what Antichrist means, one of the meanings. The other is, of course, imitate. And I believe the 2 beasts in the 13th of Revelation represent these 2 aspects of Antichrist. One, against Christ, a blasphemer. The other, a false prophet. He acts like he's a lamb, but he's a wolf in sheep's clothing. And he attempts to imitate Christ. Now, we're told also he'll wear out the saints. Now, that doesn't mean like some of us preachers do on Sunday morning or Sunday night. We sometimes wear out the saints. But it means literally to afflict the saints, to persecute them. And we're told he's going to do that. You read here in the 12th chapter of Revelation, verses 13 through 17. And then we're told a little horn will change customs and laws. We are going to see that take place. Now, the period of the little horn's reign is of a short duration here. We're told they'll be given into his hand until a time and times, that's two, and the dividing of time. 1 year, 2 years, and a half a year, 3.5 years. And it's during the last 3.5 years of the great tribulation that he intends or will reign, you see, over the earth. Now, that man is coming. He's going to appear here on the earth someday. There'll be a religious ruler, and he'll be a false one. And there'll be a political ruler, and he's going to be a false one. This one is going to be a world dictator. Now, verse 26, but the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume, to destroy it unto the end. Now, the judgment shall sit. It reminds us of the scene in heaven in Revelation 4 and 5 where thrones are depicted. It's determined by the one on the central throne and the Lamb, who is the executor of the judgment. Also, it is the agreement of all God's created and redeemed intelligences of heaven that the beast must be put down. His dominion must be ended, and he himself must be judged. The judgment shall sit. Can't be changed. This judgment continues through the great tribulation, and it's consummated by the return of Christ to the earth to establish his kingdom. Now, this is the period known as the times of the Gentiles. It began back yonder with Nebuchadnezzar. It'll continue until Christ comes to the earth